totally installing and configuring
NGINX Web Server with
PageSpeed Module, or commonly known as NGINX PageSpeed. We will use a CentOS 7 Linux and on this step we install and configure LAMPstack, which include Linux NGINX, MariaDB database server and PHP FPM. Then on step 2 we setting up Google PageSpeed Module or NGINX PageSpeed. This is specially intended for NGINX Web Server. So as you can know, Google developed PageSpeed both for Apache Web Server and NGINX Web Server. This software is open source and free to use, so you don't pay any more to using this software. And maybe I don't know for the PageSpeed license, maybe it's under GNU or general public license. But this software is actively developed by the core PageSpeed team at Google, and on Apache it's known as Mod PageSpeed, and where on the NGINX Web Server is scaled and GX PageSpeed. So if you are currently running cPanel VM on your cloud server or maybe on your dedicated server, you may can install NGINX PageSpeed, or both it running on Mod PageSpeed. Then the module is built exclusively for Apache, and I have the development test on cPanel VM server, and I have also installed the PageSpeed Mod PageSpeed module like this. So on cPanel VM, simply regulate your Apache AC Apache port. cPanel VM is very easy. You just click software and then configure AC Apache software. Then you can look at the customer's profile like this. Then look for Apache module, then you can search for PageSpeed, and that is simply enable if you want to using this mod PageSpeed. So the PageSpeed will make your web faster and reduce latency and bandwidth. variable also on available also on client-based server. So if you want to run NGINX backspeed on a cloud server or dedicated server without graphical user interface or GUI, you should install it and configure it manually. For the step, as I read on this text. Then let's stop the guide. Then change the current unique password. After that, run system update. And we deploy it. Then this is a newly deployed server. So we saw just sort for NGINX, and on this tutorial we will install and configuring or deploy or build NGINX from sort code, from its sort code. So we not install it from the NGINX installer like on CentOS 7 or Ubuntu. Let we run command yum install NGINX or apt install NGINX if we running Debian Ubuntu multi-user. So if you newly deployed virtual machine, don't forget to run system update so you will get any latest software packet and any other dependency and also Linux kernel, and you will get bug fix on your distribution system. for testing purpose, maybe you can select a chief $5 USD droplet from Digital Ocean, and you can put the configuration on production server with, of course, with higher spec. So for testing purpose, I always recommended to deploy on gitcloud server before putting the all configuration on actual production server, for example on expect virtual machine or dedicated server. So we will compile NGINX from source, and we will using NGINX main and brand version 1.19.7. We can look at change log. So I will prefer to using NGINX mainline brand rather than stable brand. Then mainline is generally more stable and has more feature and rather than stable version itself, and the update is actively supported and maintained on mainline brand. You can on the web on discussion on internet, you can see Stack Overflow instable as mainline. Official NGINX website says that stable development more reliable for or more bug free. In fact, the mainline is generally regarded as more reliable because they port a bug fix to it and not just critical fix as for the stable branch. On the other hand, change in the stable branch are very unlikely to affect the party module. We don't make the same comment concerning the mainline, where new feature can affect the operation of third party module. So F5 as owner of NGINX, they confirm that stable version of NGINX not mean that it's not stable. Even mainline is more stable and more bug free rather than stable version itself. As you can see on the this screen, okay, let's configure NGINX Web PageSpeed. On the first step, we need to install some prerequisites like GCC C++, GCC page array defaults, Mac, JMac, and other. And proceed. Then for incubator version, you can you can stick on version 1.12.34.3 stable, and never using the beta version. So we will use this incubator version rather than the latest incubator. So let's run this command. Then enter cd, then we can download the NPS version. Then extract the file. Then we can enter the directory incubator PageSpeed NGINX. And please don't using the beta version. Simply select the stable version. Then let's configure PSO. Okay, let's extract the PSO. Okay, after that let's build NGINX mainline from the set. Then let's on step 3, we can build NGINX with PageSpeed from source. Then let's install it from Mac. then make install. Okay, after that we shall add this NGINX user to your system. Then don't forget to copy this Red Hat NGINX in its script. So this script is very important to restart some NGINX service, like restart, stop, start, and check the status, or maybe reload. If you not install it, install NGINX from source, maybe of course we no need this in script, then on default installer of NGINX, but on Debian, Ubuntu, LTS server, or on Red Hat or CentOS Linux, it include the in its script, so we can simply the functionality and however on if we will NGINX from source, we need to add the init script without that the NGINX will not working properly. Then set the correct file permission for the init script, then run this command. Then let's just start the engine. then run NGINX test. Okay, syntax is okay. Then let's see the rest of them. Then from step 5, we need to grab directory for NGINX PageSpeed cache. Then set ownership, correct ownership. Then let's the current NGINX configuration. Not for the better user like this user NGINX. And simply add this variable. Then let's test the configuration. Okay, syntax is okay and this is successful, then we can restart it. Okay, after that we can check the server handling respond code or respond test using pull like this, and as you can see the response code PageSpeed that is indicating that NGINX PageSpeed is working properly. Then from this step we can continue to install PHP RPM and MariaDB database server. Don't forget to download the repository for CentOS 7. Then let install the 7.4. Okay, let's install the PHP 7.4. as you. Then let's edit PHP ini file and this here then we can edit the session path. Then sort VSD out case. Then don't forget to create varlib PHP session directory. Then set directory permission to 777 to restart the engine, restart the FPM service to have a FPM restart. Then you can check your PHP version like this. PHP 7.4.16. Then after that, we can continue to deploy MariaDB 5.0 in database server. So this is the latest stable version. Dan let me install MariaDB server. And as after that, we can verify your MariaDB installed version. The installed version is 10.5.9. And don't forget to secure your MariaDB installation using the following command. So just enter press. Enter me. Like we need to restart it before running the SQL Server installation. Then simply press enter. Switch to Linux Server authentication mode. Change the password, yes. And you should have at least two root password. One password for your virtual machine. And one again for database password or your DBMS system. Then remove unknown mouse user, yes. Is our program remotely, yes. Remove test database and access to it, yes. Remove refactor table, no, yes. Okay, from this step we have a LAMP stack running inside the virtual machine and include the NGINX Web Server module. So we can continue on the next video on setting up WordPress on subdomain and setting server block and test the NGINX Web Server configuration if it's working properly or not on my subdomain. Thank you and good night.